What's your sugar mama story? I've been working at a restaurant for over a year and a half now, and the same elderly couple comes in at least 3 times per week. They're both probably in their 70s at least. The woman is always in nice fur coats and has different jewelry all the time, but is kind of losing herself to her age. I don't think she has dementia quite yet, but she's not quite all there anymore. The man is constantly leading her around, walking her to their regular booth, helping her order, etc. Found out recently the poor old guy lives in his car. Basically, this woman pays for him to have a few meals with her each week in exchange for his companionship. It's kind of like a weird elderly escort deal they've got going on. It's sad, but in a weird way kind of sweet, as I've noticed he gets very protective over her and seems to genuinely care for her. He keeps all of her receipts for her, makes sure she gets exactly what she wants, and always makes sure she gets her 1.5 scoops of vanilla ice cream for dessert. How the guy survives living mostly in his car in Minnesota winters is probably solely due to help from this woman. TLDR. Elderly couple eats together all the time. Lady is rich enough and basically pays for his companionship and company. That man is gold. Sounds like he doesn't take advantage, even though he could. Please find out more about this couple. It seems like they both will need help eventually. And if she has money and family that doesn't care about her, he should, in my humble opinion, get something to help him not be homeless if she were to pass first. Met a 30-year-old widow on Xbox when I was 19. She said she played Xbox to pass the day because she was financially set for life when her husband passed and wanted to make some Xbox friends. We start playing more and more until I couldn't keep up because my controller and headset broke. She asked for my address, and after a week, I got a brand new controller and headset. I couldn't thank her enough and asked what I could do in return, to which she replied to just keep playing with her. Over the next few years, she occasionally buys me new games when they came out and even a few collector's editions if I wanted them. Eventually, we drifted apart because I couldn't find time to play with my school and work schedule. I still miss her and occasionally try and find her online again, but can't remember her gamertag or Facebook. She will always be one of my best gaming buddies I've ever had. This story hit me hard. I know how it feels to have an old gaming buddy drop off the face of the earth. Hoping you find her again someday. In my early 20s, I met an older woman around mid-40s in a bar. She was drinking alone and I stood by her to order a drink. She leaned over and gave me all kinds of compliments about my body. I said thanks and that she looked great too. She gave me her business card, realtor, and told me to text her around 2 a.m. I did. She rolled up to my place in a super nice Benz, woke up and she was gone. Next weekend she texted me an address and to be there at 8 p.m. and to clear my entire weekend for her. I did. She had a really nice 8-bedroom house. She was wild, taught me a thing or two and let me explore all kinds of crap I didn't even know I was interested in. The next weekend, same thing. I showed up and she had so much stuff for me. Really nice high-end clothes and shoes. She also bought all kinds of kinky toys for me to use on her too. She made me into a half-butt dom and I would tie her up and do just about anything I wanted to. We had a good time. Then she fell off the face of the earth. I don't regret it one bit. She was really nice and spoiled the crap out of me. She made me food and would bring it to me while I was in bed. Massaged my body dang near every day. She would sleep in a different room and between the sexual times we would have long lengthy conversations about anything and everything. Add an I am a girl BTW and this becomes an Oscar winning film. When I was 19 I dated a 35-year-old lady. She was not super rich herself but her dad was and she was very much a daddy's girl. Anyway, her dad was a realtor who made a ton of money by war profiteering. Essentially, rich people sell huge houses at a massive loss in unstable countries when they think conflict is getting too local. Her father would buy the home cheap, and if it survived the war he would turn around and sell them with huge margins after the conflict settled. That was his business. Anyway, he kept up with his rich clients and sold them vacation mansions in the States later on. Rich folk have such money to waste. He then paid his daughter, my girlfriend, 800 bucks a month to check in on the client's mansions once a month or so to make sure the mansion hadn't burned down or something. Keep in mind his clients lived in Dubai, London and never came to their vacation home in the States a single time in 20 plus years despite spending all of the money to get them furnished and everything. So me and my girlfriend would go to the mansion and just sleep in the mansion for a while sometimes. I've known other well-off people, but to this day I have not set foot in another home as huge as that freaking mansion. Their master bathroom had a separate room where the entire ceiling would shower water. 50 people could all shower at the same time in there. I got to shower in there by myself on several occasions. I don't have a specific story, but this was my father apparently when he was young. My grandmother told me how he would always go out with women twice his age. It was such a regular thing, I guess, that after date she'd just go, "So how old is she this time?" Many years later, and after my mother's passing, ironically she was only 3 years older than him. He's still doing it. He's in his 50s and his lower limit is the 70s. And he ain't messing with no broke to broke either. My mom, who works as a massage therapist, told me her boss, 42, at her spa, thought I, 19, at the time, was hot when my mom showed her pictures of me, ended up getting an ad on Facebook from her, and she told me to come down to the downtown spa where she worked at during her lunch break. Got an hour massage, crazy sex on the table, $50 and a Chipotle burrito. I did once visit a guy who had a sugar mama, a friend of the girl I was dating at the time. He was this average looking 20-year-old stoner kid who was living in a nice house in the city. His sugar mama was paying for him to go to community college. That's nice. I'd love to hear he made something of himself and snagged a job with his degree. Would make for a great story. Ex constantly bought me food and would give me money if I wanted beer or weed, but would then leave the beer and weed knowing I would drink or smoke it all. She only ever came to my apartment for sex and would then leave when I couldn't get it up again. Her mom would drop off 3-4 bags of groceries every week. She bought me my second car ever and paid for my college classes and helped me get my life on track, really. It ended pretty quick when I told her I thought I was in love with her. You weren't her main. I was seeing her for about 2 months. She was 10 years my senior. We worked together and there was always those certain looks throughout the year. She was going through a divorce with well-to-do architect and were previously bonded over depressive situations we were going through. It wasn't until I handed my resignation in and told the staff I was moving states did it kick off. She said we should go get a drink one night. Nothing happened. Then she invited me round to her place. 3 awesome kids, anything I wanted booze-wise. Food, great cook, meals and drinks out too. Very in shape, and we absolutely bonded very well in the bedroom too. It was almost perfect, except for me having sneak out at the crack of dawn before the kids woke up. This continued for about 7 weeks. I had my car packed and ready to go, and we spent one last night together before I moved. We said our goodbyes and I drove off. Last I've heard from her, as per the arrangement her request, it could have worked out, I felt. Miss ya, NX. Man, I'm sorry, that must suck. Went out drinking with my cousin on a Thursday night and we ended up meeting a MILF at the bar he'd hooked up with before. It's closing time and he invites me over to her place to keep the party going. I was supposed to stay at his place, so I didn't really have anywhere else to go. At the end of the night, she made me a bed in her guest room. I woke up the next morning with a terrible hangover and people are rushing around and I'm like, WTF is all this noise? I emerge from the bedroom and sitting at the kitchen table is my cousin, the MILF, and her 2 high school age kids. Mind you, I'm 22 at the time and my cousin is 23. MILF packed us lunches while she made her kids lunches and sent us off with brown paper bags and Gatorades. The kids were less shocked than I was. I think they were used to it. I was at a dive bar and this lady comes in, wearing yoga pants, and a tank sports bra. It was a Tuesday night. She was beautiful, looked like a hot suburban mom, early mid-40s. Had no idea what she was doing there. We got to chatting and it turns out she was in the middle of a divorce and had been moving out of their house all day. We exchange numbers and I go to her house later that night. Door opens and it's on without introduction. Through the night and later the next day, she keeps making comments about how she can't believe she's with such a younger guy. I look young for my age, so I assume that she misunderstands and I say, "You keep saying that. I don't think I'm as young as you think," and she asked how old I was. I told her 33 and she said that's what she thought. She was 55. I was totally shocked but also thought it was pretty cool. Over the next year, we had an ongoing relationship. She never cared or got jealous about who I was dating or seeing. We would even talk about sex with other people while we made love, which was pretty hot, because neither of us were possessive and it was about mutual enjoyment. She was very adventurous sexually and I felt I could open up about anything and be truly open with her, without judgment. We would go out to restaurants and she would always pay. She paid for us to take one small trip for a week together out of town, which was awesome. She always talked about how she had an older man set her up in business when she was young, and how she'd like to do the same for me. And we would talk about plans for what that would look like. She even suggested I move into her spare bedroom and be roommates, saying she wouldn't be jealous if I brought a girl home. I thought that was a bit too complicated and would work only in theory, so I respectfully declined. I moved off and she found someone her own age and we talk less and less all the time, but I keep her updated on my life. I think of her fondly and often, and tell her I love her. I consider her a very special woman to me, and she still inspires me. See, to me this sounds fantastic, but I wonder if I would have declined also. My dad. He broke up with my mom and now lives with an 80-year-old. He's 50. She's rich and he's basically homeless. But he's handsome and looks good with her. She supplied his sea addiction for years. And then she also supplied him money to chase me and my mom through the courts over custody. TLDR. 80 and 50 years old. Cougar fuels sea addiction of my dad. Bill Ponderosa. A while back I posted in a couple subreddits here for meetups. And a woman actually messaged me. We connected pretty well, and found out her job took her around the US. She also was in a poly relationship, and just liked having guy friends everywhere, so I just became another one of her boyfriends. When we started talking, it was about 2-3 weeks away from my birthday and I had told her it was coming up soon. She wanted to get me something for it, but I had felt uncomfortable telling her my address. Finally she convinced me, and about a week later, she sent me an incredible care package. It was 2 brand new games, a new hoodie, some comics, and a Funko Pop. It was a lot to spend on me even though we hadn't known each other that well. You dated a loot crut. Not exactly a sugar mama, but I have a second Tinder account with my age set to 40. In the bio I just straight up say I'm actually 23 and looking to have sex with older women. It has worked a surprising number of times with some very attractive MILFs and cougars. I had a girl give me an iMac because she liked me and we played video games together. We had never really met up until that point. She was sad my laptop was dying, so she gave me her old iMac. Most expensive and nicest gift I was ever given. Felt like a sugar mama. My time has come. I met an older MILF when I was 27. She was 43, and I think it was really more of a boy toy situation, though we were still friends. She would basically take me all around the state on her trips as a sales rep, when I had the days off from my own job, and we'd stay at hotels and just frick half the night. Then we'd wake up, frick again, and be on our way. It lasted for just over a year, and honestly, I was just so spoiled by her in terms of sex. She loved to frick out in nature, and before it ended, we had fricked in 3 national parks. We even had a thing where we'd impersonate the count with 2 national parks. And then laugh like idiots. We even had a thing where we'd impersonate the count with 2 national parks. And then laugh like idiots. I love this. 6 or so years ago I was just out of college in Southern California, living with my grandpa, and asked out a Chinese grad student after meeting her at work. On our second date, she picked me up in a shiny black Audi, said her parents leased it for her. We went to a Chinese restaurant. I had paid for food on our first date and just assumed I would keep on doing so, despite making $15 an hour at the time, because I'm a red-blooded, Korean, American man. So when she started ordering lobster, duck, and enough food to feed 8, I started getting a bit nervous. The check came and I reached for it, but she snatched it away. Got out her wallet and pulled out 3 Benjamins like it was nothing. And when she did that, I couldn't help but catch a glimpse of the stack of crisp bills, all which seemed to have a similar pattern, W. Benjamin Franklin's bald head peeking out the top. She had to have had at least 2 GS in there. I don't like going to the bank, so I just get it all at once, she said. I had way less in my name than she had in her wallet, LMAO. Anyway, she paid for the $200 plus meal and let me have the leftovers. Had my meals set for the next week. From then on we alternated paying for dates. My meals would be $or $$ on Yelp. Hers $$ plus. She eventually would pay for Disneyland tickets, Laker games, and some fantastic meals before 5 months later she graduated. Her student visa expired, and she went back to China. She was really down to earth too. Once we went to a spot near downtown and she street parked in Skid Row. I advised against it, motioning to the homeless encampments, but she said it was no big deal. Chill. Her English was good enough to hold conversation, but once we were lying in bed and it was kind of a lull, and she said out of the blue I'm funnier in Chinese, which I thought was hilarious, but also sad. Maybe because of that, we didn't text much outside of planning our weekends. I sometimes wondered whether she had 2 or 3 boyfriends she was just cycling through, lol. She didn't have Facebook, only Weibo, or some other Chinese social media. I texted her a few years ago, but the normally blue bubbles were now green. Still, we had a lot of fun and she helped get me through those post-grad broke butt blues. Hope she's doing alright. I'm funnier in Chinese. Living in a primarily non-English speaking country, I can relate. I am definitely funnier in English. I got a free personal training session at Equinox Gym. This woman working out there must have been working the same routine I was doing, because during the session, we ran into each other non-stop at the same benches machines, joking about it a ton, eventually then chatting her up the end of the session. Super pretty and fit 41-year-old, incredibly intelligent, with her own private practice doing sex therapy. We seemed to click. I'm 26. After my session, the trainer salespeople allowed me to stay and keep working out on my own. Then this therapist lady makes her way back to me prob since the trainer was gone, and we continue talking and exchange numbers to get together sometime. I figure what the heck, may as well try for this one. No more than 5 replies into our first text conversation, she straight up tells me I'm cute and she's always busy, so she's looking for a casual hookup relationship with me. I tell her oh how convenient, I'm in the same boat. Luckily she lives pretty close by too. So I've been going to hers about once a week for the last 2 months or so just to have sex and hang out. Oh, and she's also really into the zodiac and tarot cards, and she likes to analyze me and eventually wants to read my cards. IDK whatever. Small price to pay and TBH it actually is pretty interesting and sorta sexy when she talks about it. Now this wasn't a sugar mama type relationship at first, but we started going out to dinner just for fun. And even though it's not date why really, she's paid for everything since. Then it evolved into buying me some nice things, nothing too personal like clothes, but she's gotten me some nice bottles of wine, scotch, a candle she liked, you know, nice gift type things. Well, this week these gifts just went a step further. She's going to Barbados in February, and after jokingly saying I'd love to go, she booked me a ticket because, well, she says she felt like it. I'm also an avid surfer, so she wants me to surf all morning while she sleeps and then basically bang her on different parts of the island. I'm dropping $0. She's adamant about not having a relationship outside of a casual one though. For numerous reasons it isn't for her. And having spent enough time with her, I think she's genuine and I believe her. She definitely likes to spend money on me, but not in frivolous ways like more clear-cut sugar mamas. Still, I think the situation fits well enough to comment about. Who knows, maybe she'll start funding my business. TLDR. 26-year-old me met 41-year-old her at the gym, and after casual and consistent hooking up, she starts buying me dinner. Nice gift gestures, and now a 5-day trip to Barbados in February. My friend earns really good money and works for a government organization in a poor country, so she barely needs to spend anything. She's 33 and just likes younger guys, maybe around 21-25. She said it's because she enjoys the power aspect of it and she doesn't mind paying them or spoiling them, because for her, it's a power play. Works for her. Don't have one yet, but this girl I recently became FWB with asked me to be her formal date in Las Vegas, and I don't have to pay for anything. She's got the flights, hotels and even booze. She told me, it's part of our FWB contract. This is happening in February. Wish me luck. Let us know if you come back with both kidneys. He got expensive gifts all the time, was always going to fancy restaurants, and she let him drive her luxury sedan around whenever he wanted. Plus he got to stay at her swanky apartment rent-free. Cons? I don't think there were any for him. He came and went as he pleased. She wasn't particularly controlling. If anything, she was very sweet, and she was very attractive. If I could get a deal like that, I'd be foolish not to jump on it. He's not just in butthole, he's really freaking stupid too. I used to tutor this dumb as a rock high school girl in math, and I always tried to quit because it was so frustrating and not worth the money. Her mom used to convince me to stay via a hand job. Sounds more like a porno than a sugar mama story. I went to a bar one time and this cougar kept ordering pitchers of beer for me. One thing led to another and I went home to her place. Woke up the following morning to find out she was an E7 and I was an E4. Fast forward to later in the relationship, she told me that she wanted to get engaged before she left for her next duty station. I agreed, so we went to a jewelry store. She picked out a ring and asked me if I wanted an engagement present too. I picked out a fancy watch and she paid for everything. 2 days later she changed her mind about the engagement and decided she wanted to be single. At least I got to keep the watch. Sounds like you dodged a bullet. This is a story I got secondhand, but it fits the theme. We were lying in bed talking about our pasts and he told me about a job he'd had just after graduating from high school working at a corner store the summer before he went to college. The owner had a car accident and became partially disabled. The owner asked if he would like to earn some extra money working around his house while he recovered. He said things went well for about a month until one day, the store owner was gone and his wife came out to the garage in an open bathrobe. At first he just kind of blushed and turned away, but after a week or so of her turning up half naked in different spots around the house, he took her up on the offer. He said the owner suddenly doubled his salary at the store, but he only had to go there once a week and the rest of the time he was to report to the house where his salary also doubled, and they bought him a new used car. He said except for his one day at the store, he never did any work except sexing the wife, and suddenly he also had enough to cover his tuition. He went to a local college and kept that job for 2 years. The owner, with rehab, moved from a wheelchair to crutches to a cane, and one day called the young man's side and told him they were selling the house and the store and moving to Florida. He told me the old man also said, "I want you to know you saved my marriage. You think I didn't know you were sleeping with her this whole time? It was my idea. I love my wife and I'd do anything for her, but that accident changed things for us. You're young and just wanted some pee and a car and a few extra dollars for school and some money in your pocket. An older man would have come in here and hurt the house and the store and my wife too. We're moving on, but you don't have to worry about tuition. Just keep on with school, young man." He said his tuition stayed paid until he graduated, but he never saw the old man or his wife again. Met her when I was 22. She worked 2 shifts a week at work and suggested going to a movie. I was flattered and jumped at the chance. Afterwards we went to her apartment and had the most awesome sex of my young life. Next day, more of the same. Within a week, she suggested I move some of my stuff in. No need to pay rent. Her mom and dad took care of that, and the car payments, and credit card bills. Eventually I found out her family owned thousands of acres of farmland, 3 radio stations, and a television station. After a few weeks, the sex got less and less, and she began spending more time out with her girlfriends. Guys would come by too, guys wearing colors and riding Harleys. Slowly the truth started coming out. She was gay. The women were her rich girlfriends and drug clients. The bikers were her drug dealers. She needed a man to live with her to keep her rich, extremely conservative family from guessing that she liked women and cutting her off from her money. Feeling like I'd been lied to and gaslighted, I moved out after a month and ghosted her. Honestly, while I see where her actions would leave a bad taste in your mouth, jiggity, I would honestly have stayed, even knowing that she didn't really care about me sexually. Never having to pay bills would be awesome, if only for a little while. And you could have an actual relationship on the side. It's not like the girl whose house you're staying at would care. I'm a 40-year woman and this is my dream. Especially after reading all these stories. If I had money, this is exactly what I need. I want a friendly, casual, sexual relationship. I guess there is hope, lol. RIP your inbox. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.